So what makes a scholar then?
The first one is, the first condition of a scholar is that عِنْدَهُ, to him is Risalatul Muhammadiyah. He has the message Nabi Muhammad came with. He knows the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. ولذلك the Prophet, look what he said. He said in hadith Abi Ahmad narrated in his Muslim, in hadith Abi Darda, إِنَّ الْعُلَمَاءَ وَرَثَةُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. The prophets, the ulama inherit the prophets. وَإِنَّ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ لَمْ يُوَرِّثُوا دِينَارًا وَلَا دِرْهَمًا. They did not inherit from their money, by the way. What they inherited from them, what? وَرَّثُوا الْعِلْمَ. فَمَنْ أَخَذَهُ أَخَذَ بِحَذٍ وَافِرٍ. The first knowledge they inherit from the Prophet is what? The Quran and the Sunnah. That's what the Prophet gave them. وَذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ مِنْ آيَاتِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. The Quran and the Hikmah. Hikmah means the Sunnah. Those are the first two they inherit. Anyone who doesn't know anything about the Hadiths, anyone who doesn't know the Quran, he's not an alim, however much he screams on the pulpit and he screams and he screams. But I tell you this, he's not an alim, the one who knows Arabic grammar. He's not an alim. The one who knows usul al-fiqh is not an alim. The one who knows balagha is not alim. The one who, no, that doesn't make them an alim. A alim is a person, first condition, is that he has the Quran and the sunnah. That's the ulumul ghayat. He has the maqasid, the objectives, the Quran and the sunnah. All of these are stepping stones to these two. Pay attention to that. The second thing that he has is ma'rifatu wujuh al-qira'at. This man knows the different qira'at of the Quran. And Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad from Abu Darda. Abu Darda, he said, لا إنك لا تفقه كل الفقه حتى ترى للقرآن وجوها. You're not a faqih. They're taking out fiqh issues, stances that we need to take. Qa'am, khas, mutlaq, muqayyad. They're taking rulings. Abu Darda is saying, إنك لا تفقه كل الفقه. You are not going to be a faqih, as the word faqih is. حتى ترى للقرآن وجوها. Until you see different qira'at in the Quran, different recitations. This qira'at is explaining this one. ولذلك أيوب Ibn Abi Tamim al-Sakhtiyani explained what Abu Darda meant. He said, يَهَابُ الْإِقْدَامُ عَلَيْهِ. The person, when he learns qira'at and everything, he starts to realize, I need to hold back. The third thing he needs, a person who's alim, is what? مَعْرِفَةُ أَقْوَالِ الصَّحَابَةِ. He knows the statements of the Sahabas. Sa'id ibn Abi Aruba, what did he say? مَنْ لَمْ يَسْمَعِ الْإِخْتِلَافَ فَلَا تَعُدُّهُ عَالِمًا. Do not consider him a scholar. The one who doesn't hear, does not know the difference of opinions amongst the Sahabas. And he doesn't know the different views that Ibn Abbas said this, Ibn Abbas said this, Ibn Umar said this, Ibn Mas'ud said this, Abu Huraira said this. If you don't know the different views amongst the Sahabas, فَلَا تَعُدُّهُ عَالِمًا. Don't consider this person alim. Malik ibn Anis, he said, لَا تَجُوزُ الْفُتْيَا. Fatwa is not permissible for إِلَّا لِمَنْ عَلِمَ مَا اخْتَلَفَ النَّاسُ فِيهِ. Until he knows what the people differ upon. The people here, the Sahabas. And then they asked him, قِيلَ لَهُ اِخْتِلَافُ أَهْلِ الرَّأِيِ. Are you talking about the differences of the people of أَهْلُ الرَّأِيِ? He said, لَا اِخْتِلَافُ أَصْحَابِ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And then he said, وَعِلْمُ النَّاسِخِ وَالْمَنْسُوخِ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ وَمِنْ حَدِيثِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He knows the abrogated verses and that which are not abrogated. Tajuddin al-Subki, he said, إِنَّ الْمَرْأَ إِذَا لَمْ يَعْرِفْ عِلْمَ الْخِلَافِ وَالْمَأْخَذِ لَا يَكُونُ فَقِيهًا إِلَى أَنْ يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ. Tajuddin al-Subki, look what he said. Is that if a person does not know the khilaf and the reason for this khilaf, he doesn't know it. لا يكون فقيها. By the way, the word faqih and alim are synonyms. Mujtahid, alim, faqih are synonyms. He will not be a scholar. Look what he said. إلى أن يلج الجمل في سم الخياط. Until a camel goes through the needle. عبد الملك ابن حبيب, he said, I heard Ibn Majashun. Ibn Majashun is a student of Ibn Malik. I heard him say, كانوا يقولون, the scholars, يعني Malik and other great scholars used to say, لا يكون إماما في الفقه. A person is not going to be a person of fiqh, understanding of fiqh, great scholar of fiqh. ما لم يكن إماما في القرآن والآثار. If he doesn't know the Quran and the آثار. Abdullah ibn Mubarak was asked, متى يسع الرجل, when is it, متى يسع الرجل, when is it allowed for a man أن يفتي to give fatwa from himself? He said, إذا كان عالما بالأثر بصيرا بالرأي, unless he's an alim in the أثر, the text, Quran and Sunnah. And the ra'i here means a fiqh. He knows how to extract the benefits from it. The fourth thing is, لا يتتبع أقوال الشاذة. The person does not follow strange views. Wallahi, many of them are bringing أقوال الشاذة, filling it up with the ummah. And people are referring to them as scholars, weakening the hadiths based on their own hawa and desires, the way they like it. Ibn Mahdiyun. Ibn Mahdi is the sheikh of Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala. He said, لا يكون إماما في العلم. A person is not a scholar. من أخذ بالشاذ من العلم. Anyone who takes the strange and leaves off the what the ulama have stated in their works. A scholar is a person, when we look at his works, which is the fifth one, is he's what he got right and what he got wrong, what he got right is more. We don't believe our scholars are infallible, by the way. We know that they can get it right or wrong. Like in Hafidh ibn Abdul Barr, Hafidh al-Maghrib, he said, لا يسلم العالم من الخطأ. A scholar is not without mistakes. فمن أخطأ قليلا, if he does his little mistakes, وأصاب كثيرا, he gets many right, فهو العالم, he's a scholar. ومن أصاب قليلا, anyone who gets it right, some little time, here and there, he gets it right. وأخطأ كثيرا, فهو الجاهل. Also, the person who's an alim is the one who can defend the deen. He has that strength. We're hearing them saying, I got doubts. I had these doubts for so many years. You're not an alim if doubts are going to creep into you. An alim has the strength and the ability to defend the religion. The Prophet told us, عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, يَحْمِلُ هَذَا الْعِلْمَ مِنْ كُلِّ خَلَفٍ عُدُولُهُ يَنْفَوْنَ عَنْهُ تَحْرِيفِ الْغَالِينَ وَانْتِحَالِ الْمُبَطِلِينَ وَتَأْوِيلِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. They're going to become a scholars, Ahlul Ilm. They're reliable people. They will prevent from the religion, تَحْرِيفِ الْغَالِينَ, the extreme interpretation of those who try to do it. وَانْتِحَالِ الْمُبَطِلِينَ, and they will also prevent the religion from any additional thing that's been added to it. وَتَأْوِيلِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, and the interpretation of those ignorant ones. In other words, this statement, Khatib al-Baghdadi mentions in his Kitab Sharaf Ashab al-Hadith, Ibn Abdul Barr mentions it in his Tamheed, I read it from. Pay attention, Shahid. This is combining between two things. He can defend the religion with al-riwayati wa-diraya, the narrations, what he's got in his head. I was taken back when I came across a statement of Al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Ahmad was asked, can a person give fatwa if he's memorized 100,000 hadith? Of course, the Quran is finished. He's memorized 100,000 hadiths. Can he give fatwa? He said, la. He said, 200,000. He said, la. This is 300,000 hadiths he's memorized. By the way, hadith memorization from Ahmad ibn Hanbal is with the chain, of course. There's a time of chain. Mm-hmm. 300,000 hadiths. He's memorized it. Can he give fatwa? He said, no. They said, 400,000. He said, maybe. And then people come today and scream and say, Akhi, the shurut al-mujtahid that the scholars mentioned is so stiff and it's too hard. SubhanAllah, these conditions, where is it from the Quran? Yani, the person can defend the religion. ولذلك Abdul Karim ibn Awjan, when he came out and he got the leader of the Muslims grabbed him and he said, okay, he was going to be executed. And he said, execute me if you want. I'm dying and I've left like 4,000 ahadiths that I made halal, which was haram, and haram, that which is halal. The leader said to him, you're going to die for sure. This is not going to change anything. Lakin he said, يَعِيشُ لَهَا الْجَهَابِيدَ. Great scholars are going to live for this. Abdurrahman ibn Mahdi took it. He said, give it to me. Abdullah Mubarak took it. Abu Nu'aym Fadl ibn Dukayn. Yani these people sat down and they threw all the dirt and the filth he added into it. فَعِيشُ لَهَا الْجَهَابِيدَ. Our ones today, what are they doing? The doubt comes. It's a valid point. In Islam, I'm going to last conclude this one.
Okay.
In Islam, the great scholars who brought our religion to us, not only did they do that, they were the best people to have protected for the Muslims their prosperity, their glory, were the ulama. The poet, he said, إِذَا قِيلَ مَنْ فِي الْعِلْمِ سَبْعَةُ أَبْحُرٍ رِوَايَتُهُمْ لَيْسَتْ عَنِ الْعِلْمِ خَارِجَةً فَقُلْ هُمْ عُبَيْدُ اللَّهِ عُرْوَةٌ قَاسِمٌ سَعِيدٌ أَبُو بَكْرٍ سُلَيْمَانُ خَارِجَةً. Seven fuqaha is سبعة. The seven jurists in Medina that sat. These were the, إِذَا قِيلَ, if it said, مَنْ فِي الْعِلْمِ سَبْعَةُ أَبْحُرٍ, oceans in knowledge, رِوَايَتُهُمْ لَيْسَتْ عَنِ الْعِلْمِ خَارِجَةً. Their narrations, their understanding, their content. فَقُلْ هُمْ عُبَيْدُ اللَّهِ عُرْوَةٌ قَاسِمٌ سَعِيدٌ أَبُو بَكْرٍ سُلَيْمَانُ خَارِجَةً. Seven men. Which then trickled into the four imams that we have, Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, and Ahmed, and the madaris that came out from all of that. The point I'm trying to say to you is, we don't want activism from jahala. We don't want ignorant people running our affairs. We don't want it. The people we need for them to run our affairs and help us and get us out of these problems have to be scholars. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, they use an example. Ibn Taymiyyah, you're not لا تساوي قلامة ظفره. You're not equal to his nail and what he was like, and the knowledge and the understanding that Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah had. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامِ Ibn Hajar رحمه الله تعالى, he praised a book called الرد الوافر by Nasiruddin al-Dimashqi. This kitab is praising Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Hajar took that book, read it, And then he put a taqreed on it. Taqreed meaning he put appraisal on that book. And he spoke about Ibn Taymiyyah. He spoke about Ibn Taymiyyah and he said about Ibn Taymiyyah and how great he was. He said, and this is a seventh reason for a person to be a scholar, which is his students. Ibn Hajar said, praising Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُلْ لِشَيْخِ تَقِيُّ الدِّينِ. If Ibn Taymiyyah didn't have anything else, مِنَ الْمَنَاقِمِ, no other virtue, إِلَّا تِلْمِيدُهُ الشَّهِيرُ شَيْخُ شَمْسُ الدِّينِ ibn al-Qayyim. He only had Ibn al-Qayyim as his student. Al-Jawziyah, صَاحِبُ التَّصَانِيفِ النَّافِعَةِ السَّائِرَةِ الَّتِي تَفَعَ بِهَا الْمُوَافِقُ وَالْمُخَالِفُ. The people that benefit from Ibn al-Qayyim's works. If Ibn Taymiyyah didn't have no other يعني, virtue to be praised for, except that he produced Ibn al-Qayyim, he said, لَكَانَ غَايَةُ فِي الدَّلَالَةِ عَلَى عَظِيمِ مَنْزِلَتِي. That's enough to say Ibn Taymiyyah is a scholar.